Lions TV, we are sponsored by Regal Elevators and Lifts Consultants Limited, a company that is owned and operated by a Millwall fan, just like every single one of the sponsors that you can see in and around my huge suite. If you are going to do a bit of business in the madness broth that is 2020, then please keep it in the Millwall family by checking out all of our sponsors' website links in the description below or on our brand spanking new website, www.lionstv.co.uk. UK. We also passed 12,700 subscribers on YouTube overnight. So if you haven't already, please subscribe to Lions TV and that notification thing is coming along there now. If you press that bell, that will notify you every single time we upload a new video, which is very frequently, might I say, at the minute. We are also on all sorts of social media. We passed 7,000 overnight on Facebook, followers of the page. The Twitter graphic that you usually see pop up, I've lost it off my computer, so somehow I've got to get that back. But I do still have the Instagram one. Bosh, there you go. TV Lions. Nearly 8,000, I believe, on Instagram. So things are moving quite well. So that's all the begging done. This is going to be a bit of a Sunday roundup show, I suppose, because we've got to talk about yesterday's game at Oakwell, and we've got to look ahead to Tuesday's home game kicking off at... Is that kicking off early, or is that the Middlesbrough game? Can't remember. I think it's early as well. At home to Swansea at the Den. Regardless of the kickoff time, we need 3 points. But before we speak about that, unfortunately, let's look back to yesterday.
Oh.
So, yesterday's game at Oakwell. I'm going to try not to be negative. Well, I can't help but be negative because that's the way I felt about the game. But let's look at the positives. Personnel, as in players, better. A lot pacier. Moved the ball a lot quicker. Got forward a lot quicker. Ben Thompson come back from injury. Good. Mason Bennett played well. Didn't really look, although the defence tried, we didn't really look in danger of conceding any goals, although, as I said, the defence did try to fuck us up a couple of times. But, that's all the positives for me, unfortunately. Barnsley are where they are for a reason. No, they actually rock bottom of the league following Luton's win yesterday. And I just can't see how people can say it's a good performance. Okay, not everyone said a good performance. The iFollow commentators were saying it was a good performance. People in my WhatsApp group were saying it was a good performance. Then they didn't change their minds. I just can't see how it's a good performance when you can't muster a shot on target for 95 minutes. And I do accept, you know, another positive. It could have been very different. Shane Ferguson hits that free kick. That goes in, and it was inches away, obviously. Then it could have been a completely different story. But for me, I think that we're trying to dress it up. We're trying to make good of what wasn't very good. If you did think it was a good performance. Yes, we had lots of the ball. But I just think that made us, that highlighted our weaknesses even more. Because we just couldn't do anything with it. Rare occasions we got good balls into the box. People wasn't on the end of it. Or rare occasions we got into the box. People didn't know what to do with it if they did have it. It was a very strange game. Let's start out with the formation. The formation was changed. A lot of people going, why did Rowick go five at the back against the team bottom of the division? Fair point, but I will point to every other most away games we won this season with the three at the back. It seems to work well for us. We went four at the back last week against Derby. It definitely didn't work. And away from home this year, we've had success against Preston, Bristol City, good point at West Brom, lost by a goal at Leeds. Lots and lots. Forest, obviously, there's more on there. There's more in that list of decent away wins that we've got. So I think it was warranted to go three at the back. Sean Williams comes in for Ryan Woods. Absolutely the right decision, in my opinion. And again, people may be saying yesterday that I was too harsh. I thought Williams played well. Williams kept the ball well. Williams is a Millwall player. Williams knows what's expected of him. He's been a Millwall player for a very long time. He's been a first team regular for about 4 years. Now for me, he's going to understand his role in that team and his role within the club a lot better than Woods is. And I've gone right off Woods, and I'll tell you why in a minute. But Williams kept the ball well. What he also and he distributed the ball well. And what I mean was, just to counter any argument that people might put forward here, when I say Woods is taking balls off the back four and spreading 60, 70 yard passes, they're sort of to no one and they're very, very long upfield, long diagonals. Williams was getting the ball and switching it nicely yesterday, quickly as well, and got us on the front foot a few times. He also, if you notice, allowed Jason Malumbi to bomb on. Now, I don't know whether that was Jason Malumbi's got more confidence, he's more used to playing with Sean Williams, but Jason Malumbi got brought down for Shane Ferguson's free kick. He could have gone down in the second half and got a penalty, which he didn't. He then carried on and knocked a crossing and got cleared for a corner because no one had any ideas where to be positioning themselves because we don't get in these positions very often. So I think Malumbi was allowed to bomb on a lot more with Williams next to him. Obviously, the other change was one of the other two changes was Mason Bennett in for Ryan Leonard. Listen, nothing against Ryan Leonard, but you just get rid of him. You might as well pay him up. He's never going to do it in this league. He's either going to sit on the bench and be a sort of nothing player for us. He's never going to do it. He is League One Leonard, and I'm sorry, I've tried to get on board with it, but that, to me, last week was the best he could ever do, and it's nowhere near good enough for this standard. So Mason Bennett come in, a player that Gary Rowett rates, that we all know he does because he brought him to the club. And I thought we played well, Mason Bennett, one of the few standout performances for me yesterday. Now, he looked like he was blowing a bit, and he hasn't been around me all long, don't forget. When he come to us, he was a long way off fitness. He finally got fit. I feel that against Forest, that was the only time he was really fit. So yesterday, again, wasn't allowed to play against his permanent club last week, Derby. So it's been a very stop-start season for Bennett. But again, for me, he was a positive player where he did. Now, the forwards, the strikers, I don't know what to say. Matt Smith, 4 goals in 2 games. I don't think Matt Smith's the greatest player in the world, but he knows where the net is. He scores goals. He's on the pitch to score goals. And he gets dropped for Tom Bradshaw. And I'm not sure why. I'm not sure whether, you know, Bradshaw's been knocking on the door and saying, let me play against my old club, I'll show you what I've got, to Rowett. But that was a very strange decision for me, from Rowett, to drop him out. Maybe he looked at the way that Barnsley played. But as Chitty correctly said in Chatting Chit, we played to, and I noticed this as well, that's why I made it the title of his video, we played to sort of Smith's strengths in the first half when Bradshaw was on, waited too long to put Smith on, but when we did, we played to Bradshaw's strengths. I just don't think we've got, this is the thing, like I'll keep saying, I don't think we played well when people were dressing it up to be a better performance than it was, and we're clutching at straws a bit. We don't know what to do with the ball going forward. We did, and again, can we use the break as an excuse? Because look how well we played against Forest, and we have momentum. But all the other teams in all the other divisions across the world in different leagues have had to suffer what we've all suffered. No one's got an upper hand here. Everyone's in the same boat. So for me, to be completely devoid of any creativity or any ideas, it was, even the corners, I'm veering off, but I'll get back to the game shortly. The corners, I've said it before, okay, have one in front of the keeper, have one on the front post maybe. The rest come out and you run in and attack the ball. They're all going to stand in underneath the fucking crossbar. But when the cross comes, corners coming in, they're sort of from a standing start, they're already trying to lean back and get something on it. It's basics that we're not doing. So the first half, we start out and it was, we looked a bit shaky at first. We looked very shaky at the back again, I thought, despite our clean sheet. Basic errors being made. We remember Marlon Romeo give one away, which they nearly capitalised on. And then we started to get into the swing of it, but we were just still miles off. We should have been absolutely burying a team like that. And again, as Pete said in his post-match, you know, I want to get promoted. You know, I don't understand the existence if you don't want to get promoted. I don't want to be in the Premier League forever, but one season would be lovely just to look back on the years to come so we can tell our friends and tell their friends and your grandchildren, and you could take them to the Den. When you look back, I interviewed Brian all last week, the iconicness of it all, and iconicness? Anyway, just, you know, the games, the shirts, the times, the era, it is iconic. So surely we want that just for one season. As Brian all rightly says as well, which isn't gone out yet, or it might have gone out by now, it's going out tonight at some point. We get some 175 million. It would stabilise the club. We wouldn't go spending loads because Berylson just wouldn't have it. So to get up in the top division, that's what I want. So for me, yesterday was an underachievement on that basis. We got into the game and Malumbi's brought down. Shane Ferguson free kick. It's a brilliant free kick. You can't deny. I don't think Jeb wanted to let him have it, but he did eventually. And it's a brilliant free kick from Shane Ferguson. But again, I'm not digging him out individually. He doesn't do anywhere near enough for me on a football pitch. Just doesn't. I think if you're in the trenches, he's the last person you want with you, Shane Ferguson. If you're in the shit and you're 2-0 down at somewhere like Leeds and he's pissing down, he will go missing. But again, yesterday, listen, 2 games, and maybe I'm wrong, 2 games you can't knock it. He set up Smith last week and he scored, nearly scored yesterday. So it comes off the bar, gets cleared. And yes, other than that, you know, the goalkeeper technically, by the way, didn't save it. So he didn't get near it. Great free kick. It was very unlucky. And it could have, yes, been a very different story had that gone in. After that, we was on top. And Bennett gets a ball in the box and Bradshaw maybe should have gambled and gone in front of the defender. But what I'm going to say about Bradshaw is this, and I'll defend Bradshaw where there'll be Bradshaw haters out there. No striker in the world would have a fucking prayer yesterday playing on that team, because the only service that Bradshaw gets is 60-yard balls drilled up to him when he's 40 yards from Barnes' goal with a defender up his arse here. He doesn't get any service. Listen, Tom Bradshaw is not on the same planet, all-round player, as Lee Gregory was. But He is more clinical than Lee Gregory in front of goal. If you think I'm mad or you're asking me for proof on that, remember, he scored 7 goals in 7 games this season for us. Earlier on, he scored in Neil Harris's last game as well. I don't know if that's part of that 7-7. For people saying he's not a proven goal scorer, how thick are you? There is the proof. He has scored 7 goals in 7 games for us this season, which tells me Tom Bradshaw, if given the chance and given provided with a service, will score goals. That is a fact. It's there earlier in the season. Just look at the results and the goal scorers. The stats, you know, what can't speak, can't lie. It's there for everyone to see. It's all this hate for Bradshaw. I don't get it. Yes, maybe he should have gambled on that. Tell me last time Tom Bradshaw played an actually competitive match, 90 minutes, started a game. You can't judge him on one fucking chance in one game. And it wasn't even a chance. It was a half chance. After that, the poxy drinks break. I don't know why they got around it. The geezer's on disinfecting the goalpost. All right, it's part of the coronavirus rules. If that's what's got football back on the box, then so be it. But I knew it would do it, and it killed our only momentum we had. We sort of limped to half-time again. A lot of the ball in wide areas. I see a lot of people saying Jed was terrible. Jed was terrible last week. I actually thought Jed played all right yesterday. I thought he put some good balls in. I don't think he was bad at all. And we do pin too much fucking hope on Jed. Second half, slow starting again, and I will go on to say, again, we didn't hit the target until the 95th minute with Matt Smith's flick header. Barnsley had 4 shots on target in the second half. All defensive mistakes. I remember Williams giving one away. I think Hutchinson gave one away. And Bart makes, listen, albeit 4 very comfortable saves, there's only one difficult one we really had to dive. Barnsley have hit the target 4 times in the second half. We have not hit the target, so how can it possibly be a good performance? You can have all the ball you like, but have all the ball in the world. We know from the flip side of that, when Neil Harris used to manage us, teams have a lot of possession. It doesn't mean you've played well. Barnsley, by the way, and I'm glad I just remembered to say this because I haven't made any notes for today, they were playing for a draw. Make no mistake, they was not fucking interested, Barnsley. And if we had asserted ourselves even 50% of how we did earlier on in the season, we would have pissed the game, but we got no ideas going forward. Absolutely no ideas. And Kenny's right, but he says, I don't know what they're practicing all week in training. I think it's a very old way, and it's a way I like to do it as well if I'm coaching a team. Patterns of play, right? Just repetitive. Just get the ball, get the front 5 running at a back 4 with a keeper in goal in training, and just repeat, and just find a way, different ways, because that's all they need. They're not getting into these positions enough. So when we are getting into these positions, they ain't got a fucking clue what to do. And I thought it was terrible yesterday. I thought it was really bad. Like, it was not good. Barnsley were awful as well, and for the Barnsley fans saying, "Well, you're awful," and you know, you're saying we're awful and you ain't beat us. Correct, because we was as awful as you. It's not about you. It's a Millwall fan channel. You was awful, but we was equally as bad because we just got no ideas. Substitutions again. And Rowett has been praised highly. I mean, look, that's the second half done, by the way, because there's nothing to talk about because we didn't have a shot. So for those, again, saying we played well, we've not had a fucking shot there. So now you can skip from the 4 shots on target that Barnsley had. You can skip to the 95th minute now, because tell me what happened other than that. Nothing. A couple of corners come in, a couple of flick headers. Gary Rowett online on the interview he did after the game said we had 2 cleared off the line. I wouldn't agree with that at all. The flick header from Matt Smith in the 95th minute, by the way, the keeper's so far out of position. It should have been just a routine bump for the keeper. And he's sort of had a dive back. It's nearly gone in. But when we brought Matt Smith on, didn't play to his strengths. Got balls in the box in the first half, crosses from out wide. Jed putting in early crosses, Bennett whipping crosses in. Bradshaw's game, but he weren't on the end of them. Wasn't his fault, in my opinion. Then Matt Smith comes on, too late again, in my opinion. And we don't put any crosses in. We just try and get corners and put fucking 9 men underneath their goalkeeper's bar, and the keeper just comes out and takes it. It's very basic errors being made. And a severe lack of creativity. I just thought it was terrible yesterday. Honestly, I'm not trying to be defeatist. There was positives to take. Ben Thompson comes on, and he's got to be back in the starting lineup if fit. Other subs: Yuri Skalak. This is what I'm going to say. This might sound harsh, but this is God's honest truth how I feel. The interview I watched with Gary Rowett Saturday morning said a lot of youth coming through, and he actually said in the interview, Billy Mitchell's giving me a real headache. He's pressing for a start, and if things carry on as the way they are, I'm going to have to start him. So start him. I would be sick yesterday if I was Billy Mitchell or anyone else who travelled up to Dingle on. The second you go, right, 20 minutes ago, it's not working. Ref, sub. The second you see Leonard, Bedvardsen, Skalak coming towards that touchline, I would just go, game over, you've won. There's no point carrying on because we haven't got any class on the bench, which can't be helped maybe. We haven't got anyone on the bench that is up to anywhere near the first 11 standard, really, of the ones he brings on. He brings on Woods. What was the point in that? What was the point in that? And Woods did nothing. Mahoney could do something, in my opinion, but he's not introduced anywhere near early enough. And he's one of the few that's very talented and can unlock a door if he wants to turn up. But he must be losing out of it, getting 10 minutes here and there. Scalak, pay Scalak up. Get fucking rid of him. Bavarsson, get rid of him. Ryan Leonard, get rid of him. I know these aren't Rowitz players, granted, but the substitutions, it's pointless making a sub because we haven't got anyone. We have, other than Ben Thompson there yesterday, when Scalak come on, I went, oh, for fuck's sake. We might as well not bother finishing the game. You might as well go, Scalak, Bavarsson, Leonard. Just call it off. You can have the points. We ain't going to beat you, so just call it a draw. I know that don't work, but that's what I was fuming yesterday. I wasn't fuming. I'm just bored of it. We haven't got going after the restart. And yes, again, yesterday, results have put us in a position where it's amazingly not out of our reach, is it? But it's not going to happen. I'm sorry. And I hope I'm wrong. And I sometimes get stuck in my my pre-matches for being too positive and saying we're always going to win. I'll be amazed if we win on Tuesday, which probably now means we will win. But let's move on to it because I'm absolutely done with talking about yesterday. So the point, I didn't want to do this show, but in the interests of sponsorship commitments and being consistent and not being a miserable fat bastard, I did the video. So let's move on to Tuesday's game against Swansea at the Den. Swansea actually lost yesterday 1-0. I haven't looked at the league table, to be honest. I've been in the Brian Orme thing all day. So all I'm going to say on Tuesday's one, it's going to be a quick one, it's going to be this. We have got to assert ourselves early. I personally, I would go over back four. I would go Hutchinson and Cooper, although they both... Someone looks like during the break, during the coronavirus, someone switched Jake Cooper's legs around. His feet are all over the place at the minute, and Hutchinson's been slightly better, but not as great as he usually is. I'd have Romeo right back. I'd stick Murray left back. I'd be tempted to put Shane Ferguson there because I wouldn't have Shane Ferguson further up the pitch. He's good for set pieces and free kicks, but not enough for me going forward. So I'd either play Wallace or Ferguson left back, not too fussed. Then I'd have two holding midfielders, which would be Williams and Malumbi, and then I'd have three in behind. I don't even care if it's Matt Smith or Bradshaw, to be honest. I'd have the three in behind. I'd have Jed right, Tomo central, and Bennett left. If Thompson's not fit to start, I'll put Bennett central and Mahoney left, or I'll put Jed central, because again, I've said it for years and years, Jed could play on a 10, and when he went, he pretty much went up front yesterday at one point, we looked dangerous. He's our main man. Why are we wasting him on the right wing? He doesn't get into a game enough on the right wing. That's not always his fault. He is frighteningly quick. He has got absolutely zero fear, to the point he does things sometimes and I go, fuck me, Jeb, why have you done that? Because he's fearless and that's what you need. And you're going to get that with Jed. He's going to do things that ain't going to come off, and sometimes he's going to do things that will come off. I thought we played all right yesterday, Jed. I thought he was one of the few that looked like, you know, he at least wanted to know. It's a very strange situation we're in. It's a very difficult situation for everyone. Everything looks half-paced to me, and not just our team. Every game I've watched looks half-paced. Maybe it's because there's no fans there. I don't know, and that's the normal pace, but without atmosphere, it looks a bit slower. Or maybe the players can't get going because there is no fans there. Who fucking knows? But all I know is this: that's the team I play on Tuesday against Swansea, and we are going to win the game. I actually think we will win the game, but I can't keep saying it. We've got to get going. We've got to go out like a house on fire. Could even go two up front, Smith and Bradshaw. Why not? I don't know, but that's the team I'll go with. Bolkowski in goal. Show you on the screen quickly. Marlon Romeo right back. Shane Ferguson left back, fuck it, for a change. Jake Cooper, who's got his legs on round the wrong way at the minute. We have Sean Hutchinson alongside him. I'd have Sean Williams and Jason Malumbi just in front of them. Then I'd have Ben Thompson in the 10, Jeb Wallace on the right, Mason Bennett on the left, and I'd go with Matt Smith up front because he scored 4 goals in 2 games. So why have you dropped him, Gaffer? I have absolutely no fucking idea. Maybe he had an injury or a twinge or something, but he came off the bench and then he scored again, so... You put Jed left if you want, Bennett right. You put Jed in the middle. I don't care, but get pacey, get people there. Use the subs in the right way. If we're losing, don't put Scalak on. If we're winning, don't put Scalak on. And if we're drawing, definitely don't put Youri Scalak on. I'm done with Scalak. I've tried to defend him before. Pay him up and get fucking rid of him. He's an absolute waste of space, the geezer. 16 bags a week. Jesus wept. And you've got the NHS on fuck all. But listen, that's not Scalak's problem. He's done what he's done. And he's got where he's got. Good luck to him. I don't begrudge any man earning some coin. Good luck to him. So, don't bring Bavarsson on if we're losing. Don't bring Ryan Leonard on if we're losing. Just fucking try something different. Get some youngsters on the bench. You know, get rid of Ryan Woods, send him back. Eating up wages, we don't need it. I don't know why we've extended it when we've got five other midfielders. We've got Ryan Leonard, Ben Thompson, Sean Williams, Jason Malumbi and Billy Mitchell. And the gaffer saying Billy Mitchell's pushing for a start, and he's got Ryan Woods sitting there. He's brought down from Stoke. So I've not dug the gaffer out yet, and I'm not really digging him out now, but get rid of Woods. You don't need him there. He just wants to play 70-yard Hollywood balls, and even if those balls come off, we ain't got the players to deal with that if he does. We ain't got a player that's going to take it down 70 yards on their chest. Probably would be a good player and a better side again, if you know what I'm saying. So don't bring Woods on if we're losing. Going to do nothing for you. Don't bring on AOB. Or I don't even know where he is, AOB. Didn't mean to say AOB. I meant to say Bavarsom. They're like clones of each other. Don't bring him on for losing. Nothing's going to change. Get George Alexander on the bench. I don't care how young he is. If he's old enough, if he's good enough, he's old enough. And I ain't seen him, and he might be terrible. He might not be nowhere near good enough yet for the first team. I suspect he will be, because he scored goals at every level he's ever played at. Just fucking try something different, please, because that yesterday, it's just like fucking Groundhog Day with the subs and that. And I know it's only two games. I'm sorry. I'm trying not to be defeatist, but that's how I feel. On the positives, we are still in the hunt. We've got some very winnable games. Swansea obviously lost to Luton yesterday, so they're not in great shape themselves. And they're definitely beatable if we fucking decide to turn up. The one I'm worried about is the Anoraks Friday. We cannot lose that fucking... That title, that run we were on. I think it's 25 years now. Can't have Alan the Anorak knocking on my fucking front door. Can't have it. So, boys, I know you're all saying we're going for it. We're all in. You know, we're gonna give it everything we got. We're going to play for other teams' corona tests. Fucking show us on the pitch, please. Just give it everything you fucking got for that shirt, like Kenny said. That's all we ask. Everything was half patience. The half of you like didn't want to fucking be there. That's what I saw. Maybe I'm wrong. I don't know. But that's what I saw. That's my opinion. This is my YouTube channel. If you don't like it, one, don't watch it. Two, tell me I'm wrong in the comments, respectfully. Or three, slow your own YouTube channel. That's it. That's all I've got to say. Bath ruined me Sunday again, talking about it again. But, yeah, listen, no pre-match. Brian Ong's out now, or very shortly after this one. And I won't see it then Tuesday, because we're not allowed to go. Fucking coronavirus. I'll be on the box Tuesday. I'll be around somewhere watching it. I've watched two games indoors, and we've had two shit performances and two quite shit results, so I'll be looking to change that. Maybe anything I can do to help, I don't know, I'll watch it somewhere else, see if that fucking makes us any better. But I am slowly losing faith in this video and the will to live and our season. But again, you know, it is what it is. We are safe this season, brilliant. Gary Rowett will get his own transfer window in the summer, brilliant. And hopefully we can push on again as a football club. Enjoy the rest of your Sunday, what's left of it. I've got a fucking headache. Please subscribe to Lions TV. Come on, you Lions.